right before the sun rises. There's a stillness that the desert has. And the desert country, a lot of times people either love it or they hate it.
What I say to somebody that thinks that this country is just such a wasteland that it's not important to anybody, first place, I don't think you stop long enough to let it talk to you.
Welcome to El Carmen Land and Conservation Company. El Carmen is a privately held conservation area that spans from West Texas deep into northern Mexico. In Texas, El Carmen's Adams Ranch Division covers a 26,000-acre patch of rugged Chihuahuan Desert. Billy Pat and Bonnie McKinney work at El Carmen.
Boy, he is just shining in the sun.
The Red Racer is his common name. And that's a beautiful specimen right there. Non-poisonous. We always enjoy seeing them.
CEMEX and the Austin family recognized the importance of this property. And so they purchased it in 2007 with the mission of restoring the land and the wildlife and protecting this corridor that joins the two countries.
Diversity is very strong here. We're certainly in the corridor for a lot of migratory songbirds, mule deer, bighorn sheep, pronghorn antelope. We do have a lot of black bear that occur in this part of Texas that come and go from Mexico.
In this dry desert climate, everything revolves around one simple fact.
When you have water in the desert, then you have life. Water is the lifeline in the desert.
But when the property was acquired, water was limited.
Really, the only natural occurring source of water here on this property is the Rio Grande River. So it's been a practice, you know, certainly in Texas and in other states, to provide supplemental water to wildlife.
For El Carmen, that supplemental water came in the form of guzzlers.
This type of guzzler is designed to work on 7 inches of rainfall a year.
1 inch of rain equals 1,000 gallons of water in this type of water guzzler.
We have probably tripled our desert quail population here at Scale Quail through the use of these little green guzzlers. What we're calling these is a quail condo. It's got a little sloping roof on it. It's sort of like a little mini guzzler. What the birds can do is just touch those little tiny spigots and they can have a drink of water.
While they were getting the water in place, Bonnie was busy making other changes to the land as well.
Planting the cottonwood trees along the river, opening up the river corridor with the salt cedar beetles. We reseeded 563 acres of native grasses and forbs. We have gone in and repaired all of the old berms. We're not losing our topsoil, which was running literally into the Rio Grande, and we're now seeing ground cover behind every one of those berms. And they also tend to hold a little water. I approached Parks and Wildlife with a proposal to see if we could reintroduce Gambel's quail.
You know, this opportunity just seemed like a great idea. We do have some goals that we've set for Gambel's quail, one of which is to reintroduce his species to formerly unoccupied range. Knowing that we're working on a project that's helping bolster population of the Gambel's quail, it's exciting.
With the help and support of many partners, Bonnie also coordinated the release of silvery minnow and mule deer on El Carmen. While some species just show up on their own.
This spring, we have a photo on one of our remote cameras of an adult sow with 4 yearlings, and they were in excellent shape. Something that was a great surprise was the appearance of Rio Grande turkeys on the area, and that's a true indication that our habitat is really taking off. Our wildlife has got to have places to go. Our birds have to have places to go. By linking these properties up, I think we can make a big difference. Not many places that you have a view like this. It's a 360-degree view with literally no fences.